about that deal breaker?
China doesn't piss on the weather.
Well, why would they? I'm sure it was expensive.
Hello everyone, Pantoufleee here today for another leak video in which we're gonna talk about a lot of stuffs coming for Halloween, especially the new event. Before jumping into details, I wanna tell you the exact date of the Halloween event. It should start around the 15th of October. So in 5 days by now, if you're watching the video as soon as it pops out. And on Telegram, there are a lot of leaks circulating over that new event, which is gonna be a massive one. Let me explain real quick what I mean by massive. First thing first, we have an event featuring Korn, which is a metal band, and you're gonna see that the event is pretty cool because you're gonna be able to win a big prize. Just look at this, boys. Basically, Korn collab with Wargaming in order for us to get a new event, which is gonna be divided in 5 different pots. On this screen here, you can see what are the main rewards, and even if I don't really care about section 4, 3, 2 and etc, when you reach the top event, you have a chance to get the Progetto mod 46, and if you already have it, you will get 3.7 thousand gold, so it's really worth it to actually play in this event. As you can see, it seems like we're also gonna get some parts to get new tanks, or not really new tanks, but I mean premium tanks. The FCM 50 ton, some parts for it, and also the Black Dog, which is the Bulldog, the tier 8 one. After you get some gold, some certificates, some camouflages, some avatars, etc, etc, I'm not really gonna bother with this as we don't have much information. All I can tell you is that this event is gonna happen. I don't know when, I don't know for how long, and I can't tell you if it's gonna be paid to win or not. Now, let's talk a little bit about the Halloween event, but not the main reward or not even the event itself, but what we're gonna see in the shop. For this event, as you can see, we're gonna get crates, and in those crates, you will be able to get certain tanks, which are all from Halloween, except the Progetto Mod 46, which is here without being an Halloween tank, but as it's a great tank, we don't really mind. And yeah, we have several crates, as you can see, 6 for the moment. You'll have to purchase those crates in the shop, but we also have a solution for free-to-play players, because during the event, you will be able to receive some crates in order for you, if you're lucky enough, to unlock Helsing, Dracula, Lycan, etc. completely for free. But you really need to be careful and lucky, as your drop rate is only 5%, as you can see right there. You have all the percentage explained, so I'm not really gonna bother telling you this. I mean, you can read. But it actually confirmed what I said previously 1 or 2 weeks ago concerning the fact that you could get the Helsing and the Dracula for the Halloween event. All the other tanks are here as well, Smasher, Gravedigger, Tankenstein, but I think those tanks are gonna be in a special crate. I'm gonna explain to you what I mean by special crate. In the shop, we're gonna see different crates for different tanks. Here, for example, this crate is for the Dracula, because in this one, you will have 5% chances of dropping the Dracula, but also dropping the legendary camouflage of the Dracula. During the previous years, the drop rate of the legendary camouflage was around 4%, if I remember correctly, and I'm expecting Wargaming to do the exact same this year. We also have the Helsing crates, 5% chances to get the tank and 4% to get the legendary camouflage, which you can see right now on the screen. And as it went on for several Halloweens, you're gonna be able to get the Helsing and the Dracula in the shop only, or if you're lucky, through the event. You will probably be able to open 2-3 crates maybe from each. That would be really great to have 3 chances of getting the tanks. So for those of you who are free to play players, if you're lucky enough, you will be able to get them. Also, during the new Halloween event, you will be able to unlock a brand new attachment for free, which is the flamethrower. That looks really cool, and basically what it does is just throwing flames at the beginning of the battle. Not for the whole battle, because of course it would demand the devices to be extremely powerful to be able to run it correctly, especially if you are in 7v7 matchmaking and everybody is playing with this equipment, but it really, really looks cool and post-apocalyptic, exactly what Wargaming is doing for the whole Halloween events. Usually when they put some Halloween stuff, it's always really cool. Now let's talk about the main reward, which is the upcoming tier 7 tank. Look at this. Before talking about the tank, I just wanted to show you the amazing playstyle and amazing animated shot it has. Look at this. Every time you shoot, there is some kind of recoil or something in the back that looks really, really freaking cool. I'm really hyped for this tank because it's gonna be awesome. I have the statistics. Let's check them right now. First, let's talk about the armor profile. It's definitely not the best thing about the tank, even if it looks quite armored. Here, for example, if you want to know what tank is shooting, it's basically an E25 shooting with APCR at this tank. So it has an impenetrable turret. We will have to wait and see if the upper part, the thing that looks like big ass cupola, is penetrable. But if it's not, it's going to be an extremely effective tank in all down, even if your gun depression is definitely not the best, as you can see on the picture here. For the hull, it seems to be quite easy to penetrate, so I'm expecting this tank to do well in all down only. And I think Wargaming balanced it by putting it a really bad gun depression. This way, even if you're in all down, it doesn't mean that you will be able to shoot at your targets all the time. It also looks like an amazing tank to sidescrape with because it feels like this tank has paste armor on the tracks, but also a really well armored side behind the tracks. Let's not wait too much time and reveal the name of this tank. It's the Annihilator, and I truly think this name fits really well the tank because it's gonna annihilate a lot of targets. You're gonna see why, especially with its gun. This tank, surprisingly, on statistics, seems to be balanced. I mean, look at your aim time, 4.6, it's quite a lot for a tier 7 heavy. Gun dispersion sucks, 0.38, but the tank is not equipped yet, so if you equip it, you can probably drop it to 0.35, which is still bad, but not as bad as 0.38. The gun constraint, you have a fully traversable turret, and it feels like Wargaming decided to put it 8 degrees of gun depression. That was the least they could do, as the tank is so high that if you did not manage to put it a good gun depression, it would be literally useless on the battlefield as you couldn't manage to shoot your targets. It also feels like the tank is gonna be extremely mobile, as the turret turn rate is around 40 degrees per second and the hull turn rate 30 degrees. This way, it's probably gonna be a nightmare for mediums to circle the tank. Maybe light tank will be able to do it, but definitely not mediums, especially the German ones, which are known to be fat. Concerning the rest of the statistics, as you can see, you have 1,500 HPs, your DPM is incredible. And that's what made me really want to play that tank. 2.5k DPM at tier 7 for a whole reload time of 14.38 seconds when you're stuck. So if you manage to increase it a little bit, you can probably drop off to 13.5 seconds. You have 0.66 seconds to clear the clip, which means you shoot 3 shells in 0.66 seconds, and you have a huge damage per shot. Look at this, 210 with regular shells, 180 with your gold shells, and 250 with HE, which means every time you shoot, so every 13.5 seconds, you will have a burst of 630 with your regular shells, 540 with your gold shells, and 750 with your HEs. I know it might be weird for some of you, and you're already saying this tank is broken, but let me explain why I don't think it's broken. Wargaming gave it an amazing DPM on purpose because its aim time and gun dispersion sucks. And I want to remind you that every time you shoot one shell, your whole aim time has to restart. Therefore, with this tank, the only accurate shell you can shoot is the first one. The two last one, it's gonna depend on the RNG. If you have a great RNG, yes, you're gonna be broken, because it means you are gonna be able to put 630 alpha damage on whatever is in front of you, which is quite a lot at tier 7. But most of the time, I'm not expecting all your shells to go in, except if you're playing at close range. And I think that's what Wargaming intended to do with this tank, because in my opinion, if you don't play it close range, you are really gonna struggle penetrating all your shells. As you can see, you have a bad gun dispersion, and with a bad gun dispersion, if you don't aim, you are gonna struggle. That's why, in my opinion, that's how Wargaming tried to balance the tank. Of course, we'll have to wait for it to be implemented to know if it's the case or not, but for the moment, I'm expecting it to be good. Not OP, not average, it's gonna be a good tank. Don't worry, in both cases, as soon as the tank drops into the game, I'm gonna buy it and do a review. But for the moment, that's what I'm expecting about the tank. So that was overall my opinion about this and what is coming into the game. Feel free to tell me in the comments what you expect this tank to perform, how you are expecting this tank to perform. Is it going to be good? Is it going to be bad? Feel free to tell me so we can discuss about it. My name is Pantoufleee. This video is now over. Feel free to subscribe, like, and share. And I'm going to see you soon for a new video. See ya, guys.